Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel, The Teacher. And in this tutorial, I will talk about welcome screen that you see when you run any of Microsoft Office application like Word, Excel and PowerPoint. So let's get started and I am going to open Microsoft Word. And the screen that you see for the first time when you open any of Microsoft Office application is called welcome screen. So here you see on the top, the greeting message, good afternoon. And below you see a list of templates. And if here you can also see a link of more templates. And if I click this link, more templates, then you will start seeing a list of more templates. And you can choose any of these ready-made templates to start working with Microsoft Word. We will talk about these templates later on in our another tutorial. Let's get back to the home screen. So below you see a list of recent and pinned items, and by default it is set to recent. And here you can see a list of recent files that I have opened in Microsoft Word, like this one. If I want to open this file, I can just click here and Microsoft Word will automatically fetch this file from the path and will open that file. And if I want to close this document alone and want to continuously run the Word application, then what I can do, I can click on the file menu and then I can click on close button. And this way, there is no document currently open now, but Microsoft Word is still running without any document. So if I click on file and then click on new, then again you start seeing the list of the templates. And these templates are inbuilt in your Word. If you want to see more templates, then you must connect your computer with the internet. Then you will start seeing a list of categories here. Now let's go back to the home section. And here, what the benefit of this recent file is, you don't need to go to the particular location where the file is located. Let's say if I want to open this file, experience certificate, then I have to click on the open. And then I have to go to the browse section and then search for that particular file. But what Microsoft does is it shows you a list of 50 files. By default, it shows you 50 files in the recent file list. So you don't have to waste your time by searching the files in the file explorer. Instead, you can just click right here and that will directly open the file. So let me close. And to close the document, you can also press Ctrl W key. And again, I'm going to the home section. So this list is changeable. As you open new files, this list will scroll down and new files will get on the top that you have opened. And you can also see a date and time stamp here when you have opened or modified that particular file. So if you have any important file that you always want to stay in the list, as I have told you that this list is changeable. As you will open new files, the list will scroll down and new will files get on top. So let's say if you open 100 files, then you will only see 50 files, recent files. So let's say if that document is very important and you need to work on this document in a routine, and maybe 10 or 20 times you have to open this document in a day, then what you can do, you can pin this document, but just by clicking on this pin icon. And as you will click on this icon, the icon shape will get changed. And what is the benefit of doing that? Next time when you need to search this file in the recent list, then you don't need to scroll down the entire list. What you can do, you can see a separate list of pinned items by clicking on this pinned link. And here you can see all the files that I have pinned. If you want to unpin an item, just click on the icon again. Moreover, you can also customize the welcome screen. And to do that, what you have to do, you have to go to the options. And you see this options link right in the welcome screen. And if you have opened a new document, let's say blank document, and you want to open the options dialog box, then you can click on the file menu. And again, you can click on this options. And here in the journal section, if you scroll down, then you can see an option here related to the welcome screen, show the start screen when this application starts. So if I uncheck this option and apply the changes, and now I'm going to close Microsoft Word and reopen it again. And this time you will not see any start screen or welcome screen. And Microsoft Word will get start by default with a blank document. So here how you can customize this. And the next option is, let me turn this on. And the next option you can find related to the start screen is in the advanced section. And if you scroll down to the display section, then here you can see three options that are related with the welcome screen. The first one is show this number of recent documents, and that is set to 50 by default. So let's say if I change this to 4 and they hit the OK key, now I close the Word and reopen it again. Now you will also see the start screen. And here you will only see a list of 4 items. That is what that option is all about. So let me go to back again to the same options in the advanced section under display. So I am going with 50 again. And then you have this option, quickly access this number of recent documents. So if I check this option and it is set to 4 by default and hit the OK key. So what this option does, if you click on the file menu, then you will always see the 4 most recent files in the file menu at the bottom of this left hand pane. So let's again go to the options, and the final option related to the start screen is show this number of unpinned recent folders. So what that means, and it is set to 50 by default. Let me close Word and reopen it again. And here, if you go to the open section, then here you can see another link along with the documents, and that is called folders. And if I click on this link, then you will start seeing a list of folders. So which folder are these? These are the same folder from where you have opened these files. So Microsoft Word also fetch a list of folders from where you are opening Microsoft Word documents. So what is the benefit of this folder list is, if you have another file that is not in the recent file list, but it is located inside the download folder. So if you click on this download folder, then it will start exploring that particular folder. So this pinned folder list also behave like file explorer. So it makes you easy to locate your files. And I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.